So I'm trimming the strays because they are not in the right place. Now you can see the fish swimming inside, outside, like all around it. Yeah, that's the beauty of it. Coming home every time, just looking at just the fishes, it's like quite boring. So during August itself, I passed by a number of shops, have a look, see how their setup was, and I decided to go get some myself. When the tank is going well, then it feels nice. But when the tank is not like the way how you want it, it feels like a little bit of a chore, but then after a while it goes okay. By the end of it, you turn out very nice, and that's when I feel the satisfaction in there.
So when the circuit breaker happened, I think my anxiety levels had kind of increased in a sense. Being stuck at home and trying to figure out what to do with yourself. I've also realized during that time in circuit breaker, you're either two things, either a baker or a gardener. I know clearly I'm not a baker, so I went to gardening and that kind of just exploded in my house. I went to one of the nurseries and I saw like a garden in a jar and there were fishes and I was very, very intrigued. I thought it was quite an interesting skill to have as well, planting a garden underwater. For some strange reason, I can actually sit down and just look at it and admire the beauty of it. So to me, that takes me to a whole other level and it really manages my anxiety levels in a sense as well.
I wasn't expecting it to be that popular, but so far I've been selling out every class and I booked about half to a month in advance. It's been quite a surprise. It's more than just a potted plant, right? You're actually planning and designing an aquatic garden. You don't just watch a plant grow. You watch all these aquatic creatures that grow with it. And the more effort you put into it, the more beautiful it becomes. So I think there's that rewarding aspect to it. I think that makes it fairly attractive and quite addictive for a lot of people.